The Defence Research and Development Organisation has developed something new for the Indian Navy, a more advanced submarine. DRDO has achieved a crucial milestone by demonstrating an air-independent propulsion system which will enable Indian Navy submarines to operate for up to 2 weeks without having to surface to recharge their batteries. This has also provided a much-needed boost for the Atmanirbhar Bharat campaign. These AIP-fitted submarines have the capacity to remain subsurface for a longer period, in addition to being quieter than the nuclear-powered submarines. The Ministry of Defence had announced that the AIP plant was operated in endurance and maximum power mode as per the user requirements. The system is being developed by the Naval Material Research Laboratory. Now, what exactly is Air Independent Propulsion Technology, or in short, AIP? Or air independent power is any marine propulsion technology that allows a nuclear submarine to operate without access to atmospheric oxygen. Currently, the system is configured for P-75 submarines. It has got the safety, interface acceptance and permission from the submarine designer MSNG France. The firm soon will undertake the detailed design for its possible integration to the first available P-75 platform. What is P-75? Project 75 or the Kalavari class is a class of diesel attack submarines based on the Scorpion class submarine that are being built for the Indian Navy. They take their names from the first submarine that had been inducted into the Indian Navy. Now let's find out how AIP fitted submarines are different from the rest. Legacy diesel electric submarines operate silently underwater for up to 48 hours. But they have to surface soon to run a generator that recharges their batteries. It makes them vulnerable to detection by enemy radar, which easily detects submarine snorkels jutting on the surface of the water. This vulnerability can be reduced by powering a submarine with an AIP system. This enables underwater operations for up to 2 weeks. However, AIP fitted submarines also need to surface every fortnight for battery charging. But that still makes them difficult to detect as nuclear-powered subs. Also, let me tell you, there is still something better than that. The fuel cell-based AIP, which generates power through the reverse electrolysis of oxygen and hydrogen. In this process, the two elements chemically combine, thereby generating electricity to charge the submarine's batteries. This process does not need air, rather, it requires the storage of highly inflammable hydrogen on board. This is not true of the DRDO's AIP system, which relies on the innovative phosphoric acid fuel cells technology. It is more rugged and tolerant of fuel impurities, offering longer life and efficiency. Moreover, it is much safer since it does not require hazardous hydrogen to be stored on board. The technology has been successfully developed with the support of industry partners L&T and Thermax, which has reached the stage of maturity to fit into the target vessels. Even after this massive development, there is still a long way to go. The DRDO, after successfully testing its AIP on a land-based prototype, will now evolve this into a marinized AIP system that can fit into an actual submarine and operate underwater in live conditions. Though NMRL is expected to operationally field its indigenous AIP only by 2023-24, this might come too late to power the 6 new submarines that the Navy is currently tendering at a Rs 45,000 crore program called Project 75I. The DRDO's AIP system will be retrofitted into 6 Scorpion submarines from 2024-25 that are being built in India under Project 75. This project and the AIP development in submarines will emerge as another addition to the government's Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India initiative.